Fresh roses in my garden need the rain. I've been hoping for clouds, but the sun remains. Fresh roses in my garden need the rain.
Hi guys, sorry for the long wait. Maybe 1 week of not posting. I don't know, my phone is still broken. And a bit of OOC, but who cares? To heal with you, chapter 18, I don't have to tell you. The morning after Christmas party was hell for Kay. He couldn't sleep a wink yesterday night because he snapped at Shoyu. He unconsciously avoided doing that since he knows how hard it is for Shoyu still. Tsukishima Kay was not one to panic, right? He is for sure. That is, unless confronted for his actions. And moreover, if he who confronted him is himself. Kay was pacing in his room, not that much of course, because this is him, the salty composed bastard French fry. He had ordered purple poppies from outside the country that arrived today to give to his angry friend? Crush? Let's go with friend, shall we? Right. Friend. Anyway, Kay could not pinpoint why he was pacing up and down the house, over and around the garden, to and fro in his room. Son. Dad. Kay. Mom. You've been pacing since 3 a.m. Did you even sleep, Moonlight? Kay let out a sigh and sat on his bed with slumped shoulders. His parents took the spaces beside him and comforted their youngest, Kyo with a hand on his shoulder and Kyoko with arms wrapped around Kay's head. The bag under your eyes suggests so. Right. I mean, I just can't tell them I'm panicking over losing Shoyu, right? You already did, Kay. I said that out loud. Moonlight, dear. What did you do to Shoyu? It's fine, Mom. I got it covered. If you say so, then okay. But I won't hold back if you don't make out before the year-end party. You mean make up? Could be both. Kyoko let go of her grip as Kate gave her a playful glare. She got up and dusted herself off. Anyway, I can't give you love advice as a woman because I'm pretty sure you're the man in the relationship. You have a man-to-man talk with your father about your conduct last night. Kay rolled his eyes at his mother as she walked away chuckling. He plopped back on his bed and took off his glasses to pinch the bridge of his nose. Man-to-man talk, huh? I'm not yet in love. I know that. But I'm not sure if I like him. Well, for starters, how did you know you liked Tadashi? Had a wet dream of me and him? Not helpful. I started sharing my strawberry shortcake with him. That was before the dream, of course. Well, how about Shoyu? Would you share even a tiny bit of it to him without pouncing on him and threatening him with a fork? Why that was so graphic is because you did that to Aki a year back. Right. Maybe not. Kay rolled over to his side and somehow managed to secure a stegosaurus in between his arms in no time, all while scrunching up his nose. Even if he asks? With puppy dog eyes? We both know how nobody can say no to those. Speak for yourself, Kay. I turned him down easily, and so did Kyoko, Akane, and Akitero when he asks for something outrageous. You're the only one who never says no when he does. I'm not. Your friends aren't counted because Shoyu won't think of asking a lot from them. Okay, but what about Akitero? He asked for a 10-layered cake just because, while doing the eyes from the start. Typical Shoyo. Okay. I'm no doctor, but I can diagnose you as in love is blind mode because your range of typical is Akane-san spoiled. I am not in love. Okay, like is blind mode then. Kay felt a hand ruffle the back of his hair and a weight leaving the bed. Kay, I don't have to say it to you, right? Kay grunted a response which made Kyo laugh and close the door behind him. Left to his own silence and thoughts, Kay analyzes his father's words. He closes his eyes and snuggles into the plushie as he starts to mutter. Imagine sharing to Shoyo a piece of cake. I can totally say no to those eyes, I think. Not that I have. But Shoyo always asks for small things. Shoyo doesn't ask for big things. Then Kay remembers Shoyo wanting his wrongdoer to do what he wanted, a bouquet of purple poppies and a ballroom dance that isn't very common anymore. The realization had Kay opening his eyes and him racking his brain for the stranger Shoyo asking him big things for him in the past. He finds none. Kay knew. He rolled to lay on his back and unfortunately knew. He knew why he couldn't sleep. He knew why he was panicking. He knew why he was anxious to lose Shoyo. He knew why he immediately bought flowers to be sent in the morning after for the redhead. He knew why he could imagine sharing his strawberry shortcake to Shoyo. He knew he could never say no to those eyes, puppy dogs or not. He knew why spoiled Shoyo was typical Shoyo. He just knew. And it felt like it was supposed to be. It is supposed to be. I like Shoyo. And that was it, guys. The end of chapter 18. I am so fucking sorry that I could not post because my phone is still very, very, very damaged. Like, the screen is so cracked. There's black spots everywhere. But I'm still using it to edit this, although there are lines, and mom's not gonna buy me a new phone, and I'm really, really sad. So I got depressed and I didn't want to edit. So, like, yeah, I'm so sorry, and well, bear with me, and bye bye.